Okay, we're downstairs in my not-so-neat workshop, and I'm here to show you the tools that I used and also walk you through a little bit of the process that was used for switching out the armrest from the 97 XJ and putting in the Grand Cherokee's armrest with the slide-out cup holders. Very thin. This is what you've got in your XJ. Very easy to get out. Two screws screw out, and you're able to pull it off the console. Up here, two screws for the latch here if you want to mess with trying to replace latches. I don't recommend it. I think you're getting into too much work, and I really don't think that the benefit's going to pay off because installed, the Grand Cherokee's armrest is on very solidly on the console. It's a pretty good match once you take off the flashing of the plastic and you get rid of the extra bits of hinge. And here's one of those extra bits of hinge that had to be cut out. Not much work. So what do you need to do all of this? Well, you need a gold Sharpie in order to mark off those parts of the hinge on the Grand Cherokee's armrest that need to be cut. You need your Phillips screwdriver in order to pull out the various screws and screw them back in. The ribbon bar is key. The ribbon bar is key because in order to get the hinge off of the Grand Cherokee's armrest, you're going to need to unscrew the screws on that armrest, and you're going to pull it out of its leather holder, and then you're going to slide the ribbon bar in from the back along with the cup holder extended, and you're going to very gently pry the two pieces apart so that the plastic clips that lock together are able to slide out. So you're able to slide out the cup holder portion of it. Then you'll be able to pull out the center portion of the Grand Cherokee's armrest, and then you'll be able to get to the hinge, and the hinge is what you really need to get to in order to make the modifications. So once you've got the armrest apart from the cup holder and you're able to pull out the hinge, you're going to put the hinge next to this hinge, and then you're going to mark with the gold marker what elements of that Grand Cherokee hinge need to be cut off. And it's really just a little flashing, maybe a quarter of an inch to almost half an inch on either side. You only need to take off on the right side of it, as you look at it, this one piece, which is, you don't need it. So you also need to have 11/84 drill bit in order to make those two cuts into the other hinge. You're going to need to have a set of pliers or something else to help break off the plastic walls that run along on either side of the Grand Cherokee's armrest. You're going to need a drill in order to make those two drill holes in the other hinge. Then you're going to need a grinder with a metal wheel on it in order to cut off those extra pieces of metal on the hinge. Really useful. I have one of these too, so you don't have to try and jimmy it on a piece of wood. Really, very simple modification. Some of you guys might want to look at it and say, hey, well, what if I take this off and make it locking? I looked at it. The unit on the Grand Cherokee is pretty intricate for it. I just left it on because you really don't need to bother with it. It's pretty solid on there. But if you're going to be need to do a detail work on it, then it looks like you could take it apart, slide this in, and then probably put in, I don't know, some 6/32 nuts and bolts and clamp it into place, and then it'll lock in place and be even stronger. That's up to you, but this is a no-brainer modification for the Jeep Cherokee. Hope you do it. Made life easier. The kids already like having their pop in the back.